Hey guys, Kris here. In this video, I'm talking about me selling, yes, my Audi e-tron 55 that I have parked right behind me. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about why I'm selling it, what I'm replacing it with, and why. And most importantly, you guys have the opportunity to help me decide my next EV, the replacement for the Audi e-tron 55. So down below in the comment section, there will be a pinned comment, and then if you press that, there will be a few cars below that you guys can vote for. So the car that gets the most upvotes will most definitely be, well, heavily considered. I'm not saying that it will most definitely be the car, because, well, if it's around 50-50 or close, I may be casting the deciding vote. But yeah, be sure to go down below, give this video a thumbs up, also subscribe to the channel if you aren't subscribed, and hit that notification bell, and also vote for the car you guys want me to buy. Before I go ahead and tell you guys the EVs I've been looking at and which EVs you can vote between, I want to give one of you guys the opportunity to actually purchase this Audi e-tron 55 from me before I actually put it up for sale on finn.no, which is the marketplace here in Norway for selling cars. Because if you are looking for an e-tron 55 with this spec, now is your opportunity. You guys know the history of this car. I bought it new 11 months ago. I have a video on the delivery, so you guys can see the actual moment I see this car for the first time. And you know, I've been taking care of this like every other car. I wash it often, I keep the interior clean, especially I take care of the leather, where I wipe it with, you know, baby wipes or wet wipes almost daily, because if I do that, you keep away the dirt never sinks into the leather, and the leather stays fresh, it stays clean, and it stays matte. I'm gonna show you guys, you know, some B-roll here of the interior. This car has done 25,000 kilometers and it looks brand new. And you can say that about every car that has done 25,000 kilometers, even though that isn't a lot of kilometers. I've taken care of this car. I'm proud of, you know, how well I have kept it up, but there are a few things. So one thing is the small damage I have up front from one of the times I was charging at a lightning charger at Circle K in Furuset, where I hit the pole. So I have some broken plastic down below in the splitter. It's not apparent if you don't know about it, but I'm going to overlay some B-roll so you guys know what that looks for. Of course, if you're looking for a car like this and you want, you know, a rebate because of that and you want to fix it, you know, I will be more than willing to give you guys a fair price, because I want to, well, get rid of this car as quickly as possible so I can replace it with something new. So again, if you want to buy this car from me, if you like the spec, link in the description down below to my email. So write me an email or write me a DM on Instagram. And if you guys aren't following me on Instagram, there you will get daily updates, you will get behind the scenes, and you will get, you know, more up to date with what is happening in, well, the day-to-day basis, because these YouTube videos are often a day to maybe almost a week after the actual event, because, you know, I have to edit them, I have to schedule them. But if you want to know what is up to date with current events, follow me on Instagram down below. So just quickly, why am I selling this Audi e-tron 55? Well, first off, I think this is the absolute best car I have ever owned. It's the most comfortable, the most quiet, and for being this size of vehicle, it may also be the best handling. It's not the biggest. I've had XC90s, which are bigger, but you know, XC90s are huge. It also doesn't have the best range, but now in summer, it's no problem, you know, hitting 300 to 350 kilometers on the motorway at motorway speeds. WLTP is like 426 something. You can easily do that on a Norwegian country road. I could probably take this car from Oslo to Bergen, which is, you know, 450, 460 kilometers without even charging it now in summertime. I will be doing the last video, the Norwegian high-speed run in this car, which will be the next video. And also guys, if there's a buyer out there who's like, you know, I'm gonna buy this car now, and I don't mind if you put another, I don't know, 5,000 kilometers on it and gives me a fair price, I really want to do a Europe road trip with this car. I think that would be awesome, especially after I just took, you know, the Polestar 2 down to the north of Italy, to Genoa. If you guys want to see that, comment down below. And also, if you're a buyer who wants to buy this car but doesn't mind, you know, me putting on, well, around 30,000 kilometers in total before you purchase it, well, let me know, because I really want to do that. But if somebody wants to buy this car with 25,000 kilometers, which is the current mileage, I totally get that. But I love this car. I love the interior. I love the spec. You know, I spec this myself. It's white exterior, black optics package with, you know, the tinted windows, with the laminated glass, you know, the double pane glass, with the black roof rails, with the 20-inch Audi sport rims. I love this spec, and here in Norway, you don't see a lot of cars with this exact spec and these wheels, and that's also the reason I spec'd it this way. These 20-inch wheels are more expensive than the 21-inch wheels above them, but I think they look cool, and they are much more rare. So I love this car to death, and, you know, it's a pity I'm selling it. If I could, I would have kept it, because I love driving it. I love, you know, driving the sporty Polestar 2 and then hopping into this, having this luxurious SUV on air suspension where you can raise and lower the suspension. The stereo in this, the Bang & Olufsen stereo, is the best in any car except for the Bowers & Wilkins systems I had in my XC90. But it is now time to move forward. I had this car for 11 months, done 25,000 kilometers. I've done the videos I want to do on this car, and I want to move into, well, something a bit newer, something hopefully which will be even more popular than this car. So now to the part you guys have been waiting for, the actual replacement for this e-tron 55. And there are a few cars I've been thinking of. And what I've been wanting to do for the longest of time is to do a collaboration with a car dealer where we do, you know, the whole maybe speccing process, we do the whole purchasing process and the delivery and all of, you know, that good stuff, which is the experience of buying a new car. Because I started this channel, my very first video more than 5 years ago was me taking delivery of my first Volvo XC90. That's how I started this channel. I took my phone, I put it into selfie mode, and then I made a terrible video compared to the quality I make today. But I mean, that was the start of the channel. So I've tried to include you guys in most of the purchases I have done. I like watching these types of videos, and that's why I like making these types of videos. And I think it gives a lot of value to you guys. And also, it may give a lot of value to a car dealership. So in exchange for them, you know, being featured in a video, they can give me a good price. And I want to be upfront with this, because if I can do this with a dealership and they can give me a good price, it's win-win for everybody. You guys get the cool content, you get the experience. I get the car that I can purchase, have for, I don't know, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, put some kilometers on it, do the videos I'm not able to do with a press car, so I can do all my tests, I can drive around Norway, I can drive to the south of Europe and back again, you know, put 10,000 kilometers on a car, and then I can sell it, hopefully breaking even. That's my plan. So me and most likely Marcus Biel are going to do a collaboration, because, you know, I've done videos with Marcus Biel before. Earlier this winter, they lent me a Tesla Model 3 for 2 weeks, and I could have borrowed it for a longer time, but I was like, I've done the content now, I want to move on to the next car. But they've been so cool. They've also been, you know, doing collaborations with Bjørn. So they're one of few dealerships here in Norway who understand the value of being featured in these videos, and I think it's so awesome. So what I'm going to do with them, most likely, it's not set in stone yet, because you guys still have the opportunity to, well, cast a vote and, you know, help me decide what to do. So option one is an Audi e-tron GT. I found a beautiful car in Germany. It's white with the black optics package. You know, it looks like this on the outside. A beautiful spec, but it has a different interior and it doesn't have the Bang & Olufsen. That's because I can get it for a good price. This car is brand new, it's like a month old, done 900 kilometers. I can get that car, they can help me import it. You know, I purchase it from them, and then I can drive it 10,000 kilometers and then I can sell it hopefully to a viewer who wants that car for a very good price. The plan is to price it the lowest of all e-tron GTs in Norway, so you guys get the value and I break even. That is the plan. That's option number one. Option number two is Porsche Taycan. Either rear wheel drive with a big battery pack or 4S. Again, do the same thing with them where they, you know, import a car from Germany, a car with, you know, that's basically brand new with very low kilometers. And then, you know, I drive that car, do all the tests, all of my Norwegian tests and all of, you know, driving through Europe, put 10,000 kilometers on that car, have it for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months. And then I sell it to hopefully one of you guys. The third option is Taycan Cross Turismo. So the price of the e-tron GT and the rear-wheel drive Taycan or 4S, there are around the same. It's around the same, but getting a Cross Turismo is a bit more expensive. So personally, I would like to wait to buy a car until, you know, the prices in Germany have come down, because I can, you know, if I buy it now, most likely I will lose maybe 50 or 100,000 kroners over the next 3-4 months. And yeah, this YouTube thing isn't paying me enough to afford a loss like that. You know, so that's why it's important for you guys to, you know, click the like button and also subscribe, because the more viewers we get, the more likes, the more subscribers, the more, well, YouTube revenue I get, and then the more flexibility I have to do things like that. So right now I don't want to do that, but I do also have the opportunity to put in an order for a brand new one, but I won't get that delivered before November the earliest, or maybe December. So I mean, that's on the back burner. I could still get an e-tron GT, drive that for 3 months, do all the videos, and then, you know, take delivery of a brand new Taycan Cross Turismo. So I don't know, but still I'm on the fence, because yes, that car is going to be popular and probably go for over list used, but I don't want to take that risk. I don't want to take that risk. But again, if one of you guys are willing to, you know, pay around list for, or yeah, for a Taycan Cross Turismo that I take delivery for in November, December, and, you know, in about 6 months, well, let me down below, because it's all up to you. You guys are helping me doing the deciding here. And then we have the fourth and last car that I don't think will get a lot of upvotes, but again, vote for the car down below you want me to purchase. That is an Audi e-tron S. So that's the 60, that is the S version of this. People call it the S, some people call it the 60. And you know, I haven't decided if I want the normal SUV shape or the Sportback shape. Again, you guys can vote down below. And that is also cheaper. That's the cheapest option here. But it's also a car I would absolutely like to test over, you know, the long term, over between 3 to 6 months. But if I do this, you know, every 3 to 6 months, I could potentially have switch up my car 4 times a year. The reason for doing this is to have, you know, the most popular cars at the most popular time. That will help my channel grow. It will be, you know, something you guys want to watch. It will get views, you know, and also it will be fun to test new cars and switch up the car. So that's what I want to do. That is the reason I want to do this collaboration with a car dealership, because if I just went to, I don't know, bought an almost new car at a car dealer, or I expect a brand new one, I would most definitely lose money, because what I'm selling this car for, even though hopefully I will get a fair price, I'm still going to lose about 100,000 kroners plus on this car over 11 months. And, you know, you don't have to be a mathematician or to have a master's degree in economics to understand that that is not that is not a good economical decision. But I feel that I've, you know, done the content on this car. I drive the Polestar a lot, and you know, I'm going to have press cars. So if I'm going to have a personal vehicle, it has to be something you guys want to watch. And you know, Porsche in Norway, as far as I know, don't have press cars, so I'm not able to just go out and borrow a press car. But even if I was, I wouldn't be able to do the videos I want to do. So guys, that is the reason I'm selling this car. That is the cars I'm going to get. So it's between the e-tron GT a Taycan rear-wheel drive or 4S, or a Cross Turismo, or an Audi e-tron, either Sportback or Station Wagon 60. So those are the four cars you guys can vote for down below. And yeah, I hope you guys interact with this video. It would be very cool, and I like including you guys. That's why I started, you know, vlogging on Instagram and being active there to be, yeah, more, to include you guys more in the YouTube channel. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, please drop me a thumbs up down below, and for more car content, as always guys, please subscribe. See you guys later, and goodbye.